What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. We're going to be talking about sponsorship. I get tons and tons of questions all the time about sponsorship, and this video has probably been long overdue, but I've been a little bit hesitant about putting out a video about sponsorship because I guess I don't feel like I'm an expert in that field, but I get the question so much that I wanted to put something out that I think is beneficial to everybody, because I think I have a lot of knowledge about how it works and how I've gone through the process in order to get sponsored and to have relationships with companies. So I want to put that out there so that way it can help you guys out, especially the younger kids that are watching this that want to get sponsorships, because I want to, you know, provide you good information so that way you know exactly what you're getting into when it comes to sponsorship. So if you think this video is something that you're gonna like, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. And if you're new to the channel, I really hope you subscribe, and I hope you watch this video all the way through and get some benefit from it. Because no matter what, whether you're into fishing like I am or you're into something else, the key to sponsorship's all the same. And I'm not an expert, and I'm not the best sponsored fisherman out there by any means, but I wanna share what I think is key to sponsorship and what I think is something that's important for you guys to keep in the front of your mind when it comes to sponsorships, how to go about getting sponsored. So stay tuned with me. Let's get into this video and let's talk about sponsorship. So the first thing that I think is really important to think about when it comes to sponsorship is it's about the company. The important part is delivering for that company. Because if you're not delivering for that company, that sponsorship's gonna go away. And I think that a lot of times people twist it and think about it all about what you're gonna get as a sponsored person, whether it's a discount or whether it's product or whether it's money or something else. But really, the sponsorship boils down to what you can do for that company. For example, like I have, I'm on 6sense Pro Staff. If I can't deliver any return to 6sense, they're not gonna keep me on their pro staff, because pro staff is there to benefit the company, because the company wants those fishermen to put out content, talk about their baits, to put that information in front of other fishermen so that people will buy those products. Now, this isn't a sales pitch that's a bad thing, because you guys have seen me catch fish on these baits. They catch fish. I throw them. I pretty much throw 6sense baits all the time. Sometimes I'm throwing a jackhammer chatterbait, or I'm throwing maybe a plastic worm that I made myself, or a jig that I made myself. But if you guys are watching my content, you know I throw these baits a lot, and you know I catch a lot of fish on them. So when I'm talking to you about the baits, I don't feel like I'm selling you on these baits. I feel like I'm just talking you through the process and talking to you about what I'm doing with these baits to catch fish so that you can go out and get these same baits and catch these fish, because I want to provide value to you guys and I want to provide value to 6sense. And I think the best way to do that is to show you guys that these baits work, because I want you guys to catch fish. I want you to keep coming back to my content because it's valuable to you, it's entertaining to you, because it's something that you enjoy watching. And I want to connect you with stuff that's going to catch fish, because if I am talking to you about stuff that doesn't help you catch more fish or not something that you like, you're not going to continue to watch me. So there's a vested interest in me connecting you with quality stuff and me wanting you to get that stuff, because one, it shows that I'm doing my job for 6sense, but it's also connecting you with good equipment that's helping you catch more fish. So it's a win-win for everybody. That's the beauty of what sponsorship can be, because it's not about me getting, you know, free baits or money or whatever the deal is, because every deal is a little bit different, but it's about me trying to help them sell more baits, help them sell more product, depending on what company it is. That's what sponsorship's about. It's not about me individually. It's about the company that's supporting you. And I wanna make sure that I'm clear. In the beginning of a sponsorship, especially when you're young, if you don't have the influence that you need in order to really move a lot of product, you're not gonna be able to fish more because you're sponsored. You're gonna maybe get a discount on some stuff. It might help you out depending on the company, depending on the deal. But it's probably not going to be a deal that really makes it to where all of a sudden you can fish more, because that's something that I get a lot is kids will message me and say, hey, how do I get sponsored? I need to make sure that I can get some more baits because I want to be able to fish more and I don't have enough baits. Well, that selfishness of wanting the baits so you can fish more is something that you need to change. You need to change that mindset, because you need to have something to offer a company so they're willing to give you the baits, so that way you can promote those baits and then get people to buy them. If they're gonna give you a bait that costs $5 for them to make and you don't sell any of those baits for them, that was a bad investment on their part. So that's where you gotta think about sponsorship. Take a television commercial for a second. The company pays the television company the whatever the fee is to have that commercial. If that commercial doesn't deliver sales to that company, they're not going to continue to run that commercial, and they may not continue to run it on that show or on that channel, because that investment that they made in that commercial didn't produce results. That's what sponsorship's about. If you, as a sponsored fisherman, can't produce results, you're not benefiting that company. So you need to benefit that company in order to stay a sponsored person. And depending on what's important to that company depends upon what you need to do in order to help them, because sometimes people don't always have the ability to sell stuff, but maybe you're a great photographer and you can take awesome pictures that they can use to sell. Maybe you're a great video editor and you can help them with editing videos that they can use to sell. So there's different ways that you can get into the sponsorship world and be a valuable asset to a company. But when it purely comes down to, I want baits to go out and fish so I can fish more, that's not really the way it works. You need to get those baits so that way you can catch fish on them, so that way you can promote them and hopefully get other people to buy them. That's how sponsorship works. That's how anything works, whether it's a fishing company or whether it's another company. One of my biggest supporters is GCI Outdoors. I want to make sure that I'm delivering on my sponsorship obligations with them, that I'm getting my posts out there, and that they're authentic. When you're seeing me post about liking their chairs or liking taking their stuff out to the beach or using their tables when I'm camping, I'm actually doing that. I actually enjoy using those products. I like going out and spending time with my family or going camping or doing whatever I'm doing. When I'm including those products into my content, I'm enjoying that process. I like their chairs. I like their tables. So that's the perfect situation for sponsorship, because you want to like the stuff, because then you're really not feeling like you're selling something to somebody that you wouldn't buy yourself. I think that that's really important as well when you're connecting with different companies, is finding companies that you actually already use their products. I think that that's a key, and that's the best situation for sponsorship, because if you go out and you just start hitting up every company and you don't actually use any of their stuff, it's not going to be authentic. It's kind of, you know, it's kind of a lie if you're promoting it, because if you don't actually use it and you're not catching fish and you're just saying it's the best whatever, you know, that's not the best situation. That's not the kind of reputation that you want to start to create for yourself. So I think starting off and really targeting companies and products that you already are using is really important, because you want to stay authentic. Another thing that's important for sponsorship is having something to offer a company. And what I mean by that is when you're hitting up a company to try to get a sponsorship, because that's mostly how this stuff works, is you're going after the sponsorship. You're asking the company to be sponsored. Very, very rarely does a company really reach out to you and say, hey, we want to sponsor you. It can happen, and I'm sure depending on whatever level you are, that can happen more often than somebody that doesn't have a ton to offer, because I guarantee you companies are going to LeBron James saying, hey, we want you to be promoting our brand, and then they figure out, hey, is this going to work out or not? But somebody like me, I'm not getting a ton of people contacting me saying, I want to give you money or I want to give you product in order to promote it. So I've had to go out and search out these companies and search out these products, search out who I need to contact. And that's where this really, really gets tough, is figuring out who you need to talk to. Sometimes companies have ambassador program forms on their websites or pro staff applications on their websites, and those are good places to start, but that's not always going to get you to the right person. Sometimes you really have to do some research and find out who their marketing person, who their brand manager is, who their whatever their title is, because every company has different titles, and sometimes you actually have to talk to the owner themselves. They're the only one that can make that decision, and that's hard. That's the hardest part about sponsorship, is figuring out who you need to contact. And I can't give you that secret. I've talked to people on Instagram. I've talked to people on LinkedIn. I've called companies on the phone. I've done all kinds of different things in order to try to figure out who I need to talk to in order to try to achieve that sponsorship. So what I suggest you guys do in the beginning is start to develop something to offer a company. So that way you go to them and say, hey, I have X amount of followers. I have X amount of subscribers on my YouTube channel. I compete in all these different events. I go to these different trade shows, and these are all different places where I can promote your business, because you have to have something to offer. If you just are thinking you can contact a company and say, I want to be sponsored by you, but I'm just going to go fish with my buddies and not talk to anybody about your products, they're not going to sponsor you. That's not the way this works. So having a following, having something to offer a company, is key to sponsorship, because not having anything to offer them, it's probably not worth the risk. But if you have a large following, or a semi-large following, or a dedicated smaller following where they believe everything that you say, then that is probably a situation where you can justify being sponsored by a company. So those are things to consider, because in my specific journey and what I'm trying to achieve, because I want to fish professionally, it was very important to me to develop a social media following. I have actively tried to grow my Instagram following, trying to actively grow my YouTube subscriptions and views on my YouTube channel. I've been trying to post more on TikTok. I've tried to grow my Facebook page, and I've been fairly successful on my Instagram. I've been fairly successful on my TikTok, and I've been a little bit successful in the YouTube world, and I feel like I have a lot of room to grow in YouTube, for sure. Facebook is much more difficult to grow. You really have to spend money to run ads in order to grow on Facebook. YouTube, I haven't really figured it out yet, but I've really figured out how I can grow my Instagram. I've figured out a little bit about how to grow the TikTok, but those are the situations that I have to offer a company right now, because I can say, hey, I have 25,000 followers on my Instagram, I have 25,000 followers on my TikTok, and I have almost 4,000 subscribers on my YouTube channel. So they know that when they agree to a sponsorship with me, they have access now to those people. Their products are going to get in front of potentially those people. But if I said I got 5 Instagram followers, 1 subscriber, and 10 TikTok followers, it's probably not worth their risk, because the likelihood of you being able to make an impact on their business is pretty small. You could have the one right follower that changes their business, but they're probably not going to take that risk. I really think another thing to consider is flip it around. If you're a business owner, you're not going to just throw money out there just randomly. You're working hard to grow your business. You're working hard to sell stuff. You're working very hard to grow your business. So when you decide that you're going to give a discount to somebody, or you're going to give free stuff to somebody, or you're going to give money to somebody, you need to know that you're going to get a return on that investment. Sponsorship is an investment by the company into that person or into that event. So you see all these different companies sponsoring tournament organizations or sponsoring different events, whether it's a race car or an actual race itself, or a bass fishing tournament, for example, for something, they are paying money to get in front of you, hoping that they're going to get a return on that sponsorship. They want to show support to the tournaments that you're fishing. They want to show support for the community that is in that area. There's different reasons why they want to be there, but ultimately it boils down to they want to sell something. That's what companies do. That's what they try to do. They want to sell, they want to sell more, and they want to make more money. That's what businesses are for. That's the whole point of it. No different than you want to get a good job and you want to make more money, so does that business. So when they're going out and getting and sponsoring people, they're wanting a return on that investment. So if you flip it around and you're the business owner, what would you want to see in somebody that you're going to give free stuff to, or you're going to give money to, or you're going to give a discount to? What would you want to see if somebody was coming to you and saying, hey, I want a sponsorship? Because the next question is, okay, well, what are you going to do to help my business? You're coming to me wanting to know if I'm going to give you stuff, well, what are you going to give me in return? So that's something that you definitely need to think about when it comes to sponsorship. And I want to put a caveat out there, because I think that this is important too, is just because you watch this video doesn't mean that you can go out and follow all these steps and get sponsored, because I still have a very difficult time getting new sponsors. Sponsorship in itself is not an easy thing. You have to talk to the right person at the right time with the right thing that they are looking for, and all those things don't always line up. And sometimes it's a who you know kind of a situation, because a lot of times they want to align themselves with people that they feel that they can trust. And if they don't know you, or they don't know someone that knows you that can vouch for you, sometimes companies are going to be a little bit more leery about taking that risk once again, because it's all boiling down to risk. It's all boiling down to money. They're not a charity. They're not just out there to give you free stuff and just to say thank you for being you, here's some free stuff. You know, that's just not the way it works. So I really think that focus on having something of value to offer the company, do the research to find out who you need to contact, and start networking with other people, because the more people that you know, when you start to grow your network, you don't know always who they might know. And when they find out that you're into fishing and you're looking for sponsorships, you never know who might know somebody and they can get you connected. And then you can start to develop a relationship with that company, with that marketing director, whoever, and you might be the perfect fit for that company, and they want to sponsor you and they want to start working with you. You don't ever know, but you have to still have something to offer, because if you don't have anything to offer, you're not going to be as useful to a company as you could be. So I think some really key takeaways from this video is to not look at sponsorship as a selfish benefit to you. You want that relationship with that company to be a mutual benefit. Obviously, you want to get something from that company, but you also need to provide something to that company, because you want that sponsorship to grow. Because if you go and hit up a company and they say, okay, we'll give you whatever percentage off on our products, that might be awesome in the beginning, but eventually you might want to turn that into free product, or you might want to turn that into a little bit of money, or maybe they sponsor a tournament of yours or something like that. But you have to provide a return on the investment for them to be willing or want to do that. So that's where you need to work for those companies. Sponsorship is basically a job. You are now being an employee of that company to help them sell more stuff. No different than if you work at Lowe's and you work in the appliance section, your job is to sell more washers and dryers and refrigerators and stuff like that. So that's what you need to remember, is don't make sponsorship selfish. Make it something that is beneficial to you and that company. And my recommendation for you is make it more beneficial for that company, because now you're going to be a valued asset to that company and you're going to be able to grow that relationship. Because I think that that's where long-term sponsors come into play, because they're seeing a return on their investment. They enjoy working with you. You're working hard for them. You're trying to promote the company. You're being professional. There's all these different factors that come into play But I think that the key is you want to have long-lasting sponsors. If I were able to grow and get to the point where I could fish professionally, I would love it to have the exact same sponsors today as I do then. I don't know what's going to happen, but that's my hope. I love working with Sixth Sense. I love working with GCI Outdoors. I love running my Skeeter. I love being able to contact Last Chance Performance Marine and try to help them sell boats or tow boats to trade shows or talk about boats while I'm at, you know, a boat show or something like that. I enjoy doing that stuff. I enjoy getting out, communicating with people, talking fishing. I like to talk fishing. That's why I put myself on camera and talk to you guys and try to catch fish on camera and put these videos out. I love talking fishing. I love to go fishing. I want to make this my career. So I want to have those relationships. I want to provide a return on their investment. And I want to connect you guys with awesome products and stuff that's gonna catch you fish and stuff that I really believe in and think is quality. I don't promote GCI just because. I like their stuff. They make quality products. So when I go out and I post something on Instagram or I include them in a video or I have them sponsoring one of my tournaments, it's because I like their stuff, I enjoy working with them, and I really want to provide a return on the investment they made in me. And that goes the same for Sixth Sense. That goes the same for Owner. That goes the same for Reeler Shield, Omnia Fishing. Whatever company it is that I work with, I want to provide a return on their investment in me. And that's the key to sponsorship, is providing a return on the investment they made in you. And the better return that you can make for them, the better off you're going to be. Now, for as long as this video is, this is like the tip of the iceberg when it comes to sponsorship. And I'm sure there's going to be people that watch this video that disagree with me or whatever, and that's fine. I don't think I have all the answers. I'm just kind of talking about what I think is important, what I've learned over time, and what I think is good advice for somebody that's trying to go out and trying to find a sponsor. And I wanted to put this video out because I get that question all the time, and I wanted to be able to provide something of value, a link to a video where they can watch for 15, 20 minutes, whatever this video is, and get some solid information. So I want to thank you guys for watching. I hope that this video is valuable to you, and I hope that you subscribe to my channel. And like I said in the beginning of this video, this is a little bit different type of video. So if you're kind of checking into the Matt Luna Fishing YouTube channel to watch some fishing videos or something like that, make sure to check them out. Got a bunch of different playlists, got a bunch of different videos. So please subscribe to my channel. Please give this video a thumbs up and make sure to drop a comment down below and let's get a conversation going. Whether you agree with me, disagree with me, that's fine. Let's just get a conversation going down in the comment section. But let's grow this channel. Let's subscribe to my channel and watch my journey to fish professionally. And thanks again for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks again. See ya.